Since 2010, we've been exploring for natural gas up to 100 kilometers off the coast of southern Tanzania, operating in waters around 2 kilometers deep. One of the most modern vessels of its type, equipped with the latest in satellites and drilling technology, has been drilling gas-bearing rocks up to 4 kilometers beneath the sea floor. At these extreme depths, the gas is trapped in reservoirs, some as large as 180 square kilometers. Wells drilled into the rocks releases the gas, giving it a path to flow. We've made multiple discoveries. Extracting the gas and bringing it to shore is technically challenging, complex and costly, involving multi-billion dollar investments. Although no FID decision has been made, the plan is for gas to flow up through wellheads and then along hundreds of kilometers of subsea pipelines on the ocean floor, up the continental shelf, then onto shore. Once on land, a portion of the new gas reserves will go towards meeting demand for energy in Tanzania, where existing and potentially new gas appliance power generation is available. The gas could be used to cool and light homes, cook meals, and to power vehicles, industries, and factories. At the onshore gas processing plant, the gas will be cleaned and cooled in huge refrigeration units known as liquefaction trains. At a temperature of minus 160 degrees Celsius, the gas becomes liquid, commonly known as liquefied natural gas, or LNG. The LNG process substantially reduces the volume of the gas, similar to shrinking a football to the size of a marble. This makes the gas easier to transport safely to customers around the world, in specially designed ships. The gas is then shipped and sold abroad, with revenue coming back to Tanzania. This new high-technology industry offers Tanzania the opportunity to develop its natural gas reserves, diversifying and expanding the country's economy, attracting support, businesses, and creating jobs. An LNG export project could significantly boost government revenues, providing funds with the potential to transform Tanzania's social and economic development. We've made a good start, but much work is still to be done. Early engineering and studies on potential environmental, social, and economic impacts have been completed. A decision to proceed will come after terms and conditions have been mutually agreed between the government of Tanzania and the investors. A project this size normally takes 5 years to construct. Following a decision to go ahead, production will commence, establishing Tanzania as a leader in the emerging East African natural gas province.